creatively, one of the things I've always been good at is if I see this and this, I will usually very quickly come up with something that's like, well, here, let's do this. It's neither of these things. Why do we have to do either of these things? And the more that I learn about different styles, the more that I look at the patterns of different styles, the more that I learn music theory, well, the way that we teach music theory, because there's no one theory. There's no one set of rules that you have to look at things from. But the more I just look at the patterns of different styles that are out there, I'm just like, okay, why aren't we doing this here? Why aren't we doing this here? Why are we just, creating this same stuff? It's like, I don't know, I find it absurd with sports all these years, and we don't really have any, we haven't made any weird modifications to sports, like, how about a triangular, imagine a basketball court with three hoops, and it's a triangular court, and you have three teams, and you have to, the goal is to get to the team, clockwise to your color hoop or whatever, right? That sort of thing. I mean, just weird, something to just put a twist on things. Musically, I'm really big into odd time signatures. Why are we always using 4/4, 3/4, 6/8? It's always those kinds of things. And it's kind of funny that the songs that that people don't even notice a lot of times that are in odd timings, like Salisbury Hill by Peter Gabriel, and then Money by Pink Floyd, and those are in seven or in a 7/4. And let's see, there's the Mission Impossible theme, the original Mission Impossible theme, and that was in five. There's even like silly songs like A Man and a Woman. If you know that one, it's the one. Okay, that one. I didn't even realize until just recently that that is actually in. It's a 10. It's a slow 10. The first starts out of a 6 and then goes to 10. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7. 8, 9, 10, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10. I mean, it's a 10. And you wouldn't even have noticed it because of the way they put it together. It just kind of do-do-do. And it's like, there are some songs like, I don't like the way that a lot of rock bands will try to pull off odd timings. It's just like, ooh, aren't you impressed? Look, we did odd timings. It's not just a thing of making it flow in a like Tool. Tool, when Tool does odd timings, they're just like, ooh, aren't you impressed? Aren't you impressed? Let's impress. It's just kind of, it's the way that they go about things. And I'm just like, why not get someone into, why not create a new style altogether? Why do you have to have this style and then, oh, you'd use odd timings to impress people for a moment and then go back to your standard style? I don't get that. Well, I get it. I mean, I obviously get it. It's just people just want to continue the same patterns, but I just, in electronic music, we could just easily change the we could easily change, we could create a new style just by taking away one beat or adding one beat. And then after you get used to hearing that, you start to develop patterns within a 5 or a 7 beat, you can eventually find something that has a nice catchy kind of thing. I mean, it's not just a I'm doing it poorly, but I that probably sounded really, really stupid, but trying to get clever with it and with punjika sounds. Hey everyone, punjika, punjika. I should have just played something on the keys or something. There are all these chords that we use over and over and over again. You know? These chords. You know, those over and over again. Used in thousands and thousands of songs. Thousands and thousands and thousands of songs.
Ooh, there's Louie Louie.
And then there's stuff like, you know, oh wait, that was kind of 80s. It was a little more advanced than a lot of the stuff that we've been putting out lately, you know? There's a song by Nami Amuro that plays on the end of Inuyasha sometimes that I've always had a fondness for, and I'd thought about doing like some sort of karaoke-ish version of it. You know, I found the instrumental version of it and was just going to do the accompanying vocals and then the main vocals, do the main vocals live and have the recording of, you know, the background of all these stuff. It's like, well, why do that? Why not just like try to create a totally different version of it and stuff and produce it, put it in Renoise and all that stuff, and but like, you know, some general chords I had for something like that is like, okay, Mashima Kanashimi Afuru Nara Matiashani Mata. But then, you know, I thought about, well, maybe I could modify it even more. What if I change the time signature? So, you know, one way of playing a 7/8 version of that. Moshima Kanashimi Afuru Nara Watashimi Motarete Naitei Kara. And then here's another way of playing it in 7. Moshima Kanashimi Afuru Nara Watashini Matarate Kaitei Kara. There's someone that contacted me recently that was in... there was a band that I'd tried out for when I was right before the last time I got with the Mercury Rising. And I had obviously went with the Mercury Rising instead. But I really liked working with these guys. And he had called me yesterday, and I'm really happy about that. We're probably going to... around the end of the month or so, we'll probably, or the beginning of next month, I should say, we'll be getting together at some point and jamming and hopefully come up with something good. There's a number of bands that I've been in where the members just sort of idolize certain groups. I don't understand the idea of idolizing the bands I don't get it. If you are a musician and you're trying to get your own sound, then why would you idolize some other band? Why don't you try to... some people say, oh, your approach is selfish. Oh, you think that you're acting like you are somehow have things better than all these other people in the past. It's like, no, that's not what it is. And some people take my approach as if that's what I'm saying. It's just like, Look, if none of these people that so many people think are so well-renowned, if none of these people actually just said, no, I'm not going to try to get this other sound. This, let me just create my own sound. This is my own stuff. Let me go with it, you know? The way that some people will put musicians down for having certain kinds of attitudes. Oh, you think you can do something so much different. Well, there's no such thing as anything different. Nobody's ever done it. Everything's already been done, kind of attitudes. You know, it's like, what? Why? Why would you think that? Why would you tell someone that? There is so much we haven't done. There really is. I mean, just time signatures alone. Just that. One timing change could create 10 new styles. 10 new fucking styles. We don't do anything. But I feel the same way, like I said, about games. You know, we could tweak these few things with physics engines and, well, let's create a whole new genre of games. Oh, no, let's keep doing the same shit. I don't get it. I don't get this mindset. Why are we so artistically resistant to change here? What is up with it? Why? It just kind of goes hand in hand with tradition and culture and the times that we're willing to change and we're willing to move forward coincide with the way we're willing to change in our creative flow. You can see it. You can listen to the music. You can see what is being produced movie-wise, and anything creative, you can see this in. Frankly, the Bush years sent us back just so much. And when it comes to creative flow in that regard, it just means we're just regurgitating the same shit for years and years and years. We're just not coming up with anything new. Acting like, you know, as if you keep trying to refine something more, that's new. No, refining things isn't new. And telling people, oh, all the music that's ever been done has already been done already. No, fuck you. Anyone with that attitude, you know, it's those are the same people who try to say there are no new ideas. You know, well, if you really want to break it down, no, there are no new ideas, but we build things off of stuff that has been created already to a degree. But if we spend our entire time researching in the philosophies of all this, if we don't get our own philosophies, then I don't get this thing of how, why we're supposed to just, it's like we're supposed to connect to all these different ideologies. Oh, this, look at all these connections. No, just let me think like me. You know? It's the same thing with music. You know, people want people to connect to this style, go with this style. Well, why? Why do I have to go with this style? Why do I have to choose a style at all? I mean, music is math. It's math. We've got, there's so many, it's a formula. Every time you listen to a song, there's a formula. And we just keep rehashing the same formulas over and over and over again. I don't get it. I don't get it. So I'm hoping, you know, in the next band that I'm in, that I can push some boundaries somehow. I'm hoping and these people that I've been talking with, and I'm so glad that I've been able to talk with again, because I really liked working with them before. They're really willing to work with new stuff. They're like, oh yes, give us these ideas. Give us a new rule to go by for this next song. You know, don't do these certain things in the song. Write anything you want, but don't do these things. You know, for instance, like in a song, I could say, okay, in this song, do not use any open chords. Never go to the, and let's say on the bass player, you could say, never play the root note on this section of the song. Never play the root note. Move around it all you want. Figure out some way to move around it, but don't play this root note. In another song, you could say, never play the fifth up. Never play it, da 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 da. You say, you put a rule of never do blah blah blah, this little specific thing in the song, and the entire song comes together differently. Bam. You know? And you just create a rule for your own writing. And it's not a rule by anyone else, it's a rule you have made. It's an amazing thing you can do with these kinds of rules. It's amazing. It's amazing. I don't know. I hope I'm getting way excited and stuff, but I don't know where I'm going with this, but whatever.